danser, 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 danser.
Let's do this. It's snowing outside.
So I have to literally leave in an hour's time. I haven't even washed my face. Oh my God. Wanted to eat, have my coffee. Don't know if that's gonna work out, is it?
I have a spot here that just doesn't seem to go.
Yeah, like my skin feels like it needs a lot. I love washing my face. Don't use towels to wipe my face. I only use pads. Like, I have quite a simple face routine. What I do, I first go in with the Paula's Choice 2% BHA liquid exfoliant. So what this is really good if you have breakouts, because you're actually not meant to scrub your skin because you could be spreading them. Just let that sit for a little bit. I'm just gonna put in my eye drops. I love these because they just brighten up your eyes, but not only that, I feel like your eyes stay white for like the whole day. And I do this mostly on days, you know, when I just wanna look good. And today we're going shopping, so. And my boyfriend is coming from London. I'm so excited. I haven't seen him in like 2 months. I'm gonna go in with the La Roche-Posay SPF Milk. Oh, I love the smell of sunscreen. It smells like summer to me. I'm gonna go in with the Oil-Free Neutrogena Anti-Spot Cream. Love this. This is literally like, I think this is my 6th tube or something. I can feel like when I don't use it, my skin is so much more prone to breakouts. Oh my God, I can't wait to show you guys what I'm gonna wear.
Look at this, guys. I got this really cute vintage suit at the thrift store the other day. I love it. It was 24 euros, both of this. 24 euros. And I'm gonna style it up with you.
All right, makeup is done and we haven't got a huge amount of time, so I'm gonna jump right into it and show you guys how I styled up this really cute suit. I was thinking it was just like white sneakers. I go for this white tee, and I don't know if I should wear a layer underneath. It is kind of cold. I'm gonna wear this underneath the tee. I put on some socks. It's actually a size 16, like a UK size 16. It kind of fits around my waist. A cute fit. Like, it's not bad. Like, size 16. Like, I'm a size 10, so just to keep me nice and warm. And on top, I'm gonna go for this slightly oversized vibe. And on top, I'm just gonna remove this tag. I hope this is gonna look good. I have no time to hate it. I do love it. Wish that it had like, you know, pockets like here. If I was to take a picture in it, it would kind of look cuter if the pocket was here. For shoes, I'm gonna go for my Air Force Ones. I literally scrubbed these to death the other day because on Instagram, someone crying about my dirty kicks. I'm like, I don't know why you need to cry about the fact that my kicks are dirty. I should be crying about it. Don't know if I had more time on another day, if I would actually swap this for like a nude, you know, like a nude top in like a similar color, just so that the shoes pop a bit better. Loosely tuck it in like that. Oh my God, I love this. This is so cute. Oh my God, guys, I thrifted this Hugo Boss blazer as well for 20 quid. Can you imagine? I think if this was like spring, it was slightly cold still, I would just, oh, this is so cute. Wow. Well, it's just a bit too cold outside to do that. I'm thinking maybe my teddy bear coat, because it is really cold. I mean, it's a shame, you know, no one's gonna see my outfit. I mean, I guess inside in the store, I'll maybe take it off. Also, definitely gonna take a picture for the gram, so I'll definitely take that off. Okay, so for bag, I take my Fendi Mama, my vintage Fendi Mama. It's so slouchy, but like once you put stuff in, it like kind of puffs out. I mean, it's not a perfect match, but it is cute because we got the different shades of brown going on. So let me pack my bag. What do I need? Gonna take my little phone holder, which is kind of good to vlog with. Because I vlog with my phone, I can't be bothered with the whole camera thing. And since I'm, oh, I just turned off the light. Since I'm vlogging with my phone, I'm gonna take charger with me. Also going to pack my little Gucci purse, wallet, thingy. Look at this power bank. It is massive. Like, it's a brick. It's so heavy. I love it. It charges my phone at least like 10 times. But literally the other day, I left with my umbrella. I also wanted to take the bins out. And then once I took the bins out, I was like, where's my umbrella? I think I threw it away. Great. So if I can, maybe I'll also try and find an umbrella. And I think we're ready to go. Let's go thrift shopping.
Stay with it. You don't need to water it down. No one else has the same story. Stay with it, please.
Guys, we're just inside your wall. This is my sister. It's this really amazing bread shop in Berlin. And guess what? Yes, I can't wait to show you all the pieces that I got. Oh my gosh. Can't believe this is just a drop of water because it was raining. I love it. Oh my god, yay! And we just got some, what do we get? Oh yeah, she's got like a chocolate thing. And I got an oat milk cappuccino, and I got this big brioche thing. Look at this, it's so soft. Taste test. Oh my god, good. I didn't expect it to be this good.
This is
so good.
Mm-hmm. Mm. I am meeting my boyfriend in 3, 2, 1. Randomly found another secondhand shop and gonna try on some stuff. Tried on this jacket, but it's a bit big, so I'm gonna give it to you to try on. Happy?
Yeah.
Yes, it is freezing. Now we're gonna get some kebab.
Yay!
Kebab! I actually wanted to show you in the store what I tried on and some of the stuff. Why I got it and why I didn't get it, but this one forgot to film, so I'll show you guys what I got at home.
I've kind of just cut my hair myself, so I had to just cut it here in the bottom because it had just dangly bits down here. I do feel a bit like I'm from a different time. We're just gonna have to figure the situation out. Also, I can't gel it back how I usually do it in my usual style because I actually ran out of gel, so I'm just gonna have to rock the fro for a couple days. So I would love to say that this is the same day later on and that it only took me 2 minutes to change my entire hair, but unfortunately no, it's like 2 days later. I was just so slumped that day. We went home, we had kebabs, and then after I was just like on the couch chilling. I think I edited a video as well where I basically also showed what I got, but just like in a shorter version, so just like in a minute and a half. But I want to go a little bit more in depth with you guys, so I think I'm gonna grab the bar stool from the kitchen and pop this on top, and then maybe I can sit as well because I just ate and I'm like so slumped, so this probably won't. It does. Okay, so obviously, first of all, you saw me already in this vintage suit, which I just absolutely love. It's a little bit on the lighter side, so I am a little bit cold right now. Might also just be because I'm getting tired. I'm just gonna grab the first thing off the top and just hope that this stands up here. And then I'll insert me wearing this stuff over here. I actually haven't featured this on my Instagram yet. Look at the lining. Oh, it's so beautiful. I love it. I might actually swap this out for this one because it's a bit warmer and I'm a bit cold. Oh, I love this. So this is like a Hugo Boss blazer. And look how beautiful this is. A little bit green, beigey, but it goes really well with all my like tan outfits, I'd say. It's just, even with this, it just goes so well, doesn't it?
Classic buttons. Don't mind my nails, I have to get those done.
So literally, speaking of blazers, I think in total, in 1 week, I got like 4 blazers. Ugh, I'm obsessed. You can never have enough blazers, right? Ooh, I still got 2 really important bits outside in the corridor, but I'll keep those last because they're just chef's kiss. Those last 2 pieces, you guys aren't ready. I think this is my favorite color. Surprise, surprise. I think also it just looks so much like a blazer from the Frankie shop. And they're so expensive. And this is a Hugo Boss blazer, another one. I got this one for 20 euros. And the fabric of this, it's in impeccable condition. Like the lining is amazing. Here you got the Boss logo. Such great condition. I love this piece. And one thing I would say with vintage shopping, actually quite a few people ask me this on Instagram. At the moment I live in Berlin, but I actually think this applies to most cities because most cities have a secondhand shop culture. Even in London I used to do this stuff. So it's not really about me actually telling you guys where exactly, which exact store I went to. First of all, and actually, I watched a couple of videos on TikTok and I found them really interesting because they were giving tips on how to like thrift in a really good way. And the first point that the girl mentioned was to actually love browsing, like love spending hours within one shop. If you're the kind of person who, you know, when they go shopping, they walk into a store, they're like, kind of look around. If they don't see anything that they fancy straight away, they kind of just walk out, head to the next store. And if you're not too fond of like trying things on and just rummaging through stuff, you know, and having some patience, then I'm so sorry to break it to you, but thrift shopping is probably not for you. Everything that I'm showing you, I got over a period of 2 days. 2 days, like, you know, like some people get this within like an hour. They just grab it all online or they just go on a shopping spree with their friends for like 3-4 hours and they grab all of this, you know. But yeah, that's the first point. I think just if you are not a person that likes rummaging through stuff, I don't think secondhand shopping is for you. Like, for me, it's also therapy, you know. I love going by myself. I love not going with friends because they usually just different levels of patience, you know. And some of my friends don't have that level of patience. They skim the store and then they think, oh, there's nothing here for me. And they just kind of get bored. And obviously, I don't want to like drag them along and make them wait for me all this time. So I kind of then just rush for it. And then I can't get all into it, rummage through the stuff and find all the good bits. Maybe I'll even have some AirPods in, just listen to some music, do my thing. I find it super inspiring as well, you know. You kind of really have to use your imagination to think of certain ways you can style these items. Because I'm not going to lie, a lot of these items, the way they're just kind of shoved together in a corner, just very uninspiring. And now let me get to point number 2, which I was going to say before, is when you go into specially designed vintage stores versus like secondhand or charity shops, that's when people get so surprised of the prices. Like, vintage shopping doesn't necessarily mean that you're gonna get bargains all the time. Like, people spend a lot of money for vintage items because people care about, you know, certain clothing and their story. Also, a lot of these items, I think what we're forgetting is the reason they're vintage is because they're a certain level of quality that has allowed that item to last for 20 plus years. And that's actually the thing, like, an item is only officially vintage once it has passed like 20 years, I believe. So imagine that, like, a garment staying in such an amazing state, but imagine what that just says about an item and its quality. The fact that it's literally been through 20 years, even if it was in storage, like whatever, the fact that it is 20 years old and it still looks intact and it still is a high quality garment. It says a lot about the item. And it doesn't come cheap, like quality doesn't come cheap, you know. And if you was to buy some of these materials, which brings me to point number three, materials, looking for the right materials is the key for vintage shopping. When these things are 100% wool or like 50% wool, 50% cashmere, or all of these like amazing materials that will last you a lifetime, they don't come cheap. If you buy these straight from the shop, usually they will cost you around hundreds. Getting it for like 50, 60 or whatever, I actually don't think it's too bad. So I do understand what these vintage, like these specialized vintage stores are doing and the reason why they're selling certain things for certain prices. However, for me, you know, I do like a little bit of a bargain. Because I know I can find it, that's why there's certain things that, especially like, you know, if you're kind of more into that skater vintage style, like if you like the raincoats, if you like the vintage Levi's and all of that, find a bigger variety to choose from specialized vintage stores, I find, in different colors and sizes and whatever. However, I'm not that person. I prefer more glam. I do like sometimes wearing oversized joggers and whatever. However, the whole 90s, super colorful, also slash Y2K kind of style is not me. And so I'm perfectly fine going to secondhand shops and charity shops and finding blazers, finding suits, finding like all these amazing tailored items, all these oversized things that are currently like kind of on trend, and they cost literally, like I said it already, in a Frankie shop, they cost so much money. Sorry, I didn't want to ramble on and on and on, but I had a few questions of people who asked me, oh my god, like where are you finding all these amazing items? Like whenever I go like vintage shopping, it is just so expensive. And yeah, I just wanted to answer some of these questions. Like, don't go into specialized vintage stores who claim to mostly predominantly sell vintage items. They will be more pricey than secondhand and charity shops. However, they will be styled better. They will be more curated. So you won't spend as much time in these stores looking for things that you like or finding things that you like versus like a secondhand or charity shop. Let me get back into the bag, and if I can think of any more tips, I'll just throw them in. The next thing that I can just see here is this little vintage bag. How cute is she? Let me come closer. So this, she's beautiful. This is gonna have to be the thumbnail. Yes. I'm a sucker for a structured bag. This is kind of how it opens up. I kind of love this, you know, like I feel like without it would be cute too. I had lipstick on my chin the whole time. Why didn't you tell me? I do love the little gold detailing in the front. You know, I think it adds something, and I love gold. I always wear gold. It's giving me a bit like vanity case. It just opens and closes with a magnet. I think with an all black outfit, this would be so cute. You are not going to believe me when I tell you how much this was. I don't think you're ready for this journey. I don't think you're ready for this journey. This was €5. It's insane. Let me just say that. Kind of digested now, so I can stand up. So next off, I love this. These two pieces, they were €24. Doesn't say what fabric this is made out of. It's like Swedish or something, but it's like amazing quality. Like, the color is super like nicely done. I'm not a person who wears more than three colors in one outfit. It starts giving me anxiety. Not literal anxiety, but just a little bit. I'm just like, feel all over the place if I wear like three different color categories. However, if I was to put, you know, like some people, they would just wear like jeans and then maybe like white sneakers, a black turtleneck and a brown coat, you know? For me, that's already too much to handle because I'm like, that's a lot of colors. Like for me, denim is blue. This is the reason I am just really, really happy about this two piece because it makes my life so much easier now. It allows me to wear color. Also at the same time, it's kind of like a muted color, you know, it's like a pastel green. It's not like a bam green in your face. So it's quite easy thing to style with like some cream, maybe like a cream bag or some white shoes. The next one, oh my gosh, I don't, you know what? When I saw this, I wasn't quite sure because I was like, it's H&M. And I don't know if I mentioned to you already, but you need to make sure to look at the right materials and you need to know your brands when you go vintage shopping or secondhand shopping. Like, you can't just... The other day, I went to a store, this vintage store, this super bougie vintage store, and I saw they had this really cool, this was like this gray skirt, it was open here on the side. Kind of looked like gray shoelaces going through that side. Looked like kind of dip dyed, it was really cool. And I was like, oh my God, this skirt looks really good. And I looked in and I saw misguided. And I was like, I'm not paying 16 euros for a used misguided skirt that brand new in the sale of misguided would probably cost me a fiver. So you kind of need to know your materials and you need to know your brands. And that will really give you the opportunity to find these really amazing gems. So going back to this jumper, the reason I decided to go for it, even though it's H&M, I wouldn't necessarily go for something like secondhand from the high street, you know? Not often anyway. The reason I went for it is because it's 60% cotton. Now going back to the materials and why they're so important, because I know this wasn't 5 euros from H&M. For me, this is a complete bargain because it doesn't have a single stain. It doesn't really look like it's pretty much been worn, like the feeling. It doesn't even feel like it's been washed that much, you know? Like, it's still kind of got that kind of really stiff, hard cotton vibe to it. Next off, don't laugh at me, okay? It's a, yes, I know, they basically almost look identical. Don't laugh at me, okay? I saw this online and I saw it was Hugo Boss and I thought, even look at this lining, it's gorgeous. And this is super, super, super oversized, this blazer. It doesn't have a brand inside, but I can just feel that this is pretty decent quality. And this is just absolutely massive on me. And I kind of just, I don't know, I just thought, why not? And then for this piece, gorgeous. It's got these gold buttons everywhere. It's real leather. It's definitely been worn, like you can tell it's been worn a lot, but I think that's kind of what makes real leather pieces kind of special, you know? I don't think I would have bought this if, again, I didn't see the tag that said real leather on it. Because I'm not 100% sure, like, about these cropped items. I'm not a huge cropped girl when it comes to cropped on this length, you know? I'm more like either super cropped or mid-thigh level, or like ankle. So I'm kind of weird when it comes to here. I find them a bit unflattering and a little bit hard to style. Now guys, I have to show you my two favorite purchases. You're not ready. Look at these colors. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's got these stitching on the sides. I think this is 70% wool. And this baby right here is the showstopper. It really is the showstopper. Like, I fell in love with this coat. And then I saw the price tag of this. Let me just first tell you. First of all, look at it. How much would you reckon this it would be from like a proper store? And this is like made in Italy. And I thought if you would buy this literally right off the shop, new, I wouldn't be surprised if this was like 300. First, I checked how it looked. I said, yes, baby, I love this color. And the gold buttons are so up my street. Then I checked made in Italy. I was like, yes, that's also really good. And then I checked the material. It's a wool and cashmere blend. And then I checked the price. Guys, you just hold on to your seats right now, okay? You're not gonna believe this price. Like, it was 10 euros. I'm not gonna lie, from all the things I've ever thrifted in my life, I think this baby right here, she's the winner. I spent more money on the burger the other day than on a cashmere wool coat that goes almost down to my ankle. This coat makes me so happy every time I look at it. Just all I'm saying. Okay. Oh, like, I think that is it for this video. This wasn't too long of a vlog, but I really hope you enjoyed it anyway. Let me know which one of these pieces are your favorite ones down in the comments. Which one would you have snapped up? And which one do you think maybe I should have left in the store? If you want to see more vlogs, I think I want to move more into the vlog route. You know, I've been trying these like sit down videos and that just, I find them so draining. And the reason I find them so draining, I think, is because it's not what I'm meant to do. I'm more the kind of girl, I like just grabbing my camera and just talking about any random thing I want to talk about. So I think I'm going to be starting vlogs much more. So watch this space, and if you're interested, make sure you hit that subscribe button. I just want to thank you so much for sticking around all the way till the end, and I will see you guys in my next video. Goodbye.